Hello again, everyone. Welcome back to Dark Wizard. When we last left off, we were in the capital city of Prozal. We had just defeated the region of Baltric, and it is cell at 12. My first order of business will be to overlook the equipment I got last time from last adventure, and my friend Wizardo here came back with a shadow shield, which he cannot wield, for it is for people of chaos only, which most of my people are admittedly neutral, but this is a very nice shield. Spock is chaotic, but he is a wizard, so I guess he can't use them. Gimli is also chaotic, but I guess he is so berserk that he doesn't use shields anymore either. My priest is chaotic, so that works. Zaldrin, you were chaotic too, right? No? Okay. It seems that my priest is going to get this shadow shield. This is a very nice shield. My priest also has a magic shield, which is also a very nice shield that I bought him recently. The magic shield is good for magic users, but I believe the shadow shield is such a good shield that it outweighs the magic enhancing properties of the magic shield. Or at least, I'm going to leave the priest with the magic shield instead of selling it, just so I can compare these two things on the battlefield. You can make a better comparison there than you can here, but I believe that's fine. Okay, so Wizardo has a mermaid's harp. He needs to play this harp at the town of Willis to convert the people's flesh from stone to flesh once again. And the goddess tears, I believe they are. I'm not sure about this fun bell. I'm gonna leave the fun bell on the knight. And then Wizardo can have all the herb, because once the people are not stoned, maybe they want to get stoned again. Anyways, the knights will take the goddess tears, because we found out we need a lawful person to use the goddess tears at that oasis to please the goddess Sabrina, and that this is a story critical event, so we're gonna make sure to do that. Okay. So we got that sorted out. I'm not sure if I want to buy any new gear. I think I'll hold on to that for now. Or I'll hold off. I mean, hold off on that for now. I believe the town Willis was near the desert region, right? It was on the road. There's Willis. And here is Neely, the place I needed to take one of the amulet to. The amulet too. Was it the shark tan talisman or the normal talisman? It's one of the two talismans, so maybe I should just take both talismans? I forget now. Well, I believe it was one of the two talismans. We'll take both talismans to that town, and we're gonna need the mermaid's harp. Okay, so much for taking the herb. The herb can be with the druid. The druid likes the natural sort of thing, so that'll work. Alright, and you can't wear the talismans, so yeah. Okay, we'll kill two birds with one stone. The Wizardo will go to this region. We'll talk to the people of Neely with about the whole shark, ten dragon rider thingamajig, and then he will play his beautiful music. And I'm sure Wizardo is very good on a harp, and restore the people of Willis. Alright, I guess since this town is closer, we'll do this first. It's not like the people who are turned to stone are going anywhere. Of course, that's kind of callous. Maybe I should go to the other place first. Or do I go in here, or do I use it? I guess I'm gonna go in here and talk to people first. Ho there! I see you've got the famed blue crystal. Or right here, I've got the famed blue crystal for sale. I'll give you a deal of a lifetime. Oh, right. That guy. It's like, what? What blue crystal? But the one I gave him. Moog, Eros. Okay, maybe the mayor will care? Or do I just use the item here? Large bazaar, only because of Sabrina. Okay, so I don't think the pawn shop cares, right? I remember they sold some interesting things here, but nothing that I care for. Yeah, okay. Yeah, because it's old hat. Okay, maybe I just use the amulet here, and then something happens. I did this in the wrong order. Alright, use shark tan amulet talisman. Shark tan talisman. Okay, I might try coming back here later, but first, Willis I think will be a bit more simple. Okay, so I'm gonna try to use the harp first. Alright, that was actually a lovely little tune. I wasn't expecting that. Okay, so does that do the thing? Do I need to do something again when I get inside? Okay. Funny music. Everyone was afraid because they saw one person who did not return to normal. I'm still just laughing at this music. It's got weird voices. They sound like they're very busy people here. They're as busy as a bunch of dwarves. When they looked closely, they found out it was a stone statue from the start. Oh geez, we sure were fooled. The sculptor should be very proud. Yeah, I would say so. That's funny. Okay. Welcome, what can I do for you? Thanks for saving us. I still feel like a lump of rock. And if you say I look like a lump of rock, I'll smash you. A good one. I'll give you a special discount. Cool, alright, that sounds good. He's got some nice stuff. Nothing new. Well, a great bow. Have we... I'm not sure if I... Yeah, I think we've seen a great bow before. Sorcerer's staff. All wizards casts volcano. What kind of staff have I'm using? I think I'm gonna buy one of them. Looking for something else? Probably, but one second. I'm using a wizard staff. The sorcerer staff... Yeah, this is an antique. You can have my wizard staff. Alright, I'm wearing a holy cloth. You don't want to buy my stuff. My talismans. Alright, I'm not sure what else I should buy here, but we are getting a discount. I'm not sure if this discount will carry over. Angel's robe. Lawful. Allows low-altitude flights. There's only one person who cares about that. Oh, they sell shadow shields. Allows concealment in shadows. I didn't know that it allowed concealment in shadows. And then the mirror shield, lawful, increases resistance to magic. Okay. This music is hilarious. Alright, stop by again. What about the pawn shop? Salve, broadsword partisan, judge's stick, law and chaos. Class affects attack strength. What's that mean? That it does more damage or less damage based on your class? I guess so. Huh, I wonder which people get the most damage out of that thing. Or if that thing's... Does that mean it's good or bad? Well, it depends on who you are, clearly. Holy mace? That seems decent. Arbalests! Ooh, I don't think I've seen one of them before. That sounds pretty nice. I'm tempted to buy one of those here and now, but... I think I'll hold off for a second. What do you have to say? On the southern edge of the Grasildo mountain range, there is a mine. The best steel in the world comes from there. That's where we get the steel for our weapons. I don't have too much variety, but the quality is tops. Just take a look. Huh. Grasildo. I'll have to take a look at that. Did I miss that? Hello, Mr. Mayor. Nice green beard. Well, thank you very much for the compliment on the beard. I don't know how to thank you. I really love weapons. You know, weapon making is popular in this region because of the high quality steel. Because of that, this city came to be Cheshire's premier source for weapons. Oh, and there's a blacksmith. That's a new thing. Okay, that explains the music. This is the blacksmith village. It's like a clink clank forging. Ho, ho, forging, we make weapons. Thanks to you, we were saved. You won't go wrong if you let me temper a weapon for you. I'll give you a good deal. Come on by anytime. Okay, tempering weapons, interesting. Can you temper a sorcerer's staff? I can't do a thing with that. Okay, holy cloth? Can't do a thing with that. Okay, so I probably have to get a sword or something. Well, I mean, maybe that's why he was giving me a discount. Although, do I want to do it right here and now with one of these weapons in this shop? Protects from dragon breath. Can you armor of retribution? Wound successful attackers. So if I bought this armor of retribution, would I be able to temper it? Or would I just be wasting my money? I am not sure. I think maybe I want to bring a nice weapon to him and get it forged there, so... We're probably gonna have to come back with someone else. I don't want to waste my money. Alright. But that's alright. This was fun. That was interesting. Oh, did I actually talk to everyone? I want to make sure I talked. I think I talked to everyone. Okay, well, cool. We've got a really, really nice place for weapons and blacksmithing. Whoops, I didn't necessarily mean to end the search because I hadn't done the other thing. I hadn't figured out how to... Oh well, it doesn't matter. I thought it was... Maybe that wasn't the right town for the Dragon Quest. Doesn't matter, we managed to achieve something there, but... Is Grasildo somewhere nearby? Grasildo Mountain Range. Sounded familiar. Pretty near a mountain range, yes, then. Ridley. I don't know where that is, but anyways, we spent enough time on that. Let's make sure to complete our other task, which is to send our knights to the Oasis of Sabrina and achieve a plot critical quest. This is important. Alright, knights. There it is. There's the Oasis. A mysterious wetland in the middle of the forest. The middle of the desert. And the goddess teardrops. Lawful. There we go. You use goddess tears. Magic defense strength increase has increased. Okay. Did I do something wrong? Is there a misconception I'm having? It's not the funeral bell, that's for sure. Okay, then. Well, I think I may have got the wrong item. Was it... I think we got the wrong item there. Well, apparently we can get more shadow shields here. This place pumps out shadow shields like no tomorrow, and we know that's worth 7,000, so... at least there's something. I wonder if I can ask for more advice. I know this town talked about. I could go to an FAQ, or I could bother you good YouTube users, but I think I want to look around and get some more advice. Because this town talked about that sort of thing, right? Yeah, a shrine, glowing green. Wish you had seen it. So do I. I think I kind of did. Long time ago, there was a large oasis in the middle of the desert, but it disappeared. Well, it's back. I saw it, but I can't do anything with it correctly. I'm just kind of curious. My grandfather was the last apprentice. Yeah, this all seems very familiar. Well, the fortune teller talked about the town of Willis before, right? What do you say now? You want me to tell you about a legendary sword? You don't need a fortune teller for that. If you want to know about weapons, go to Willis. Okay. Well, that's a new bit of information, but it didn't pertain to the goddess quest. Well, okay then. I feel like I'm kind of... we're just going to move on. And I've got plenty of other things to do. I'm going to search the region I just conquered previously. We're going to move ahead, and I'll try to figure that other stuff out later. There's always more time to put all the pieces together. Did I search this region properly? I'm not sure if I did, but we'll also do that next time. Okay, so, well, first off, I need someone who doesn't have a bunch of equipment to do the searching of the previous region. Who has extra equipment, and I wouldn't mind to send out searching. Well, Bobbit is carrying 3 pieces of weaponry. How about, I really like Gimli right now. I really like Ned and the sort of thing he's doing. I could, have a Sauldron do it. Or my priests. Would be... Yeah, well, we'll have one of them do it. And speaking of which, I do want to rename. I want to rename that priest. Because he is actually quite a nice character now. Priest, you are now officially named Rodney. I meant to do it before, but... Rodney, which about perfectly fits. And is this correct? I think I hit exit instead of enter last time. Okay, so now we got Rodney, the priest. We're gonna send out Zaldrin, the wizard, who is admittedly underleveled and will be spending more time out of combat thanks to this, but it's just because he doesn't have much equipment, and I just don't feel like juggling gear a lot, so here you go. Go, Zaldrin. Discover various mysteries for me. Alright, so what is in this region? Various cities. I think... Well, first off, there was a very unique-looking spot here. Hello. There is nothing here. No, there's something here. So the magic shield is 12 defense. I think the shadow shield was like a 15, so... Actually, they're very close. They're very close, those two things. I believe, if I remember my numbers correctly. So, because Amon has the shadow shield. But still, that hiding in shadows thing sounded pretty nice. Okay, so I think I went to this town before, right? I remember you, cross-eyed lady. The new tavern owner gives me the heebie-jeebies. Right. So there was something we could do with the tavern owner, right? Goblet of Solma. Right. I'm forgetting the quest. We need to talk to the brother who is in some other town. There was some priest we needed to talk to. Crap. I'm forgetting who it was now. Okay, well, we can figure that out, at least here. And then we'll have to send someone else to complete that quest, probably, right? Was it... I'm forgetting who it was. We here at Wolf's believed in Sabrina, the fire deity, and this fire deity Solma, forced to worship Alder Arlamon. Forgive us. Somebody talked about a relation to the priest. Griffin Caves, south of Proxim Castle. Right, there were Griffin Caves. I think we were supposed to go to the Griffin Caves at a certain time of day. I don't think this is the right time. I think it was Griffin's in the afternoon, not the morning. But I might as well take a look at that. Okay, so south of Proxil Castle? Which one was Proxil Castle? I think that was this one, right? Is there a way to find out? I don't see a cave to the south of Proxil. So maybe it's on the next map. Is that the case? Yeah, it might be so far south that it's on the next map. Which, in that case, I cannot deal with that. Okay, I need a reminder on this quest, because I can't remember exactly where to look next. It was some priest somewhere. I need to talk to someone before I can confront the guy, right? Used to rest on this altar, you can see it's no longer here. In the church at Garmesh, you'll find the brother. Garmesh, okay. I forgot. Garmesh. Alright. I am on the case. Garmesh. I was pretty sure it was a priest who told me about that. Garmesh. Oh, there's the volcano. There's the volcano that if you go into it without the goblet, you burn. You burn good, you burn die. So I think me no go in there without goblets, and me no burn die, yes. Alright, so... I don't think this Garmesh is on this map, is it? Or Garmesh? I don't think it is. Okay, anyways, just looking for other stuff. Okay, well... Yeah, we'll have to... go somewhere else. I wish I had remembered that, but that's okay. So we'll have to send out yet another search party. So that wasn't in this region, right? Solma? Bols? Garmesh. It's here. Okay, it's in this region. Alright then. I guess we'll send out... Should I send out Rodney? I'm going to send out Ned instead. How about that? So we'll send out Ned, even though I like him too. Or I could have done the searching. It doesn't matter. Well, it depends on how much we find, really. Have I searched this region? There's nothing here. And what do you have on your person, just out of curiosity? The Elven Ring and the Spout Pot. So yeah, you've got a little bit of space, just in case you find something nifty. I mean, that mountain looks kind of interesting. You found a Gorgon's tail. Okay. Nice, I suppose. Alright, anyways. Let's get to the village before I forget where it is. Was this the one? I believe this is the correct one. Garmish. Nice. Okay. Church? You got some splaining to do. The goblet of Solma has been stolen? I see. This may be my brother's fault. Of course. He always had trouble controlling his appetites. He used to say he wanted to drink from the goblet of Solma. What has he done? Well, that is... clearly he has motive up the wazoo. I must apologize for my brother and myself to the goddess. Oh, Sabrina, please forgive us. C.O. Cool Sabrina. What's so cool about her again? Okay. Okay. Well, now that we've been told that we can confront him, why couldn't I confront him earlier? I don't quite fully understand that. Alright, might as well talk to you again. A spring? No one knows about? How can no one know about it? No one knows about it. Wait, my wife told me about it. Did I ever complete that quest? There's some sort of quest about that, too. There's a forest up here. That's kind of odd. Might as well search it, I guess. Anything here? Nope. It looked interesting, though. Admittedly. Those are kind of interesting, but I'm not sure if they're unique enough to be bothered with. Alright, yeah, I feel like there's a lot of quests that I'm missing. But that's okay, I just wanna make progress in the game, so... The main storyline is the thing I care about the most at this point. And next time around, I can clear a lot more of these side quests. In any case, now we gotta send out yet another search party back to this region. And this time, yeah, I don't care. It can be me. I'll do this. I'll do it. I can confront people. I'm great with confrontations. I'm actually not bad when it comes to that sort of thing. I mean, nobody likes confrontations when they're negative, but I can certainly stand up for myself and that sort of thing. That's too. When it comes down to it, I can be assertive, and physically, I usually do okay as well. Anyways, so let's have a confrontation. Alright. No! How did you find out? Was it because everyone in both villages told you about the way I took the cup and how I've been acting really suspicious? Well, I won't let you have it! It's mine, I tell you! Mine, mine, mine! No! I can't! I can't take it anymore! I'm so sorry, please, believe me, I'm not evil. I just couldn't control myself. The wine from this goblet was so delicious, but it's over now. I'm glad. Glad, I tell you. Here, take the goblet. But please keep this a secret. I have a reputation to think of. It's pretty much screwed up, but by the way, can I ask for one favor? I just want to drink out of it once more, please? Well, okay, fine. You now have the goblet of Solma. Nifty! Alright. Please, let me have one last drink. Just give me the goblet for 1 minute. I can see he's not gonna stop. Alright, I'm gonna have to cut you off. This is the first time I've had to cut off a bartender instead of the other way around. Alright, so... I got the goblet. Can I just go dive in the volcano now, or do I need a wizard or someone to do this properly? Oh, well, I can't do that space. I think I'm gonna need a wizard. I should have thought about that. The Goblet of Solma. You can't use it. I wish I had brought a wizard. I should have thought about this. Once you get the goblet, you're gonna need to use a wizard. This is gonna inevitably tie up a lot of people. Because I can't go in. I can't go in with this character, right? Is that how it's working? Or just use it around the area? Goblet of Solma. Because this isn't where the fire spirit is. There was something important to do with the volcano here, I'm pretty sure, right? No, last time I used the goblet, it was nearby. You can't use it, okay. Or do I just search and go in? Okay, yeah. I guess I'm gonna have to hand it off to someone else. Okay, I feel like I'm doing things not quite right here, but we're close. So anyways, we're gonna advance just because I don't want to... Well, actually, I do want to send Andrew... We're gonna be tying up a lot of people this time, just because I'm doing things inefficiently, but who cares. That's just the way the cookie crumbles. I'll just have to complete the next map with less people. But I want to send Andrew to the town of Willis. Actually, before that, I want to make sure I have enough money. So, one last thing. I'm going to sell the silver axe. As I don't think we'll need the silver axe. Even though it's a nice axe. Silver axe. I don't use it. I need money, so I'm going to sell the silver axe. That way, Andrew will certainly have enough cash when he goes to the town of Willis to potentially try to temper his sword, which is a very nice sword, but I'm thinking it could potentially be even better, and that would be pretty crazy. So have a go at that, Andrew. And then there is a rumor of an even better sword that we can learn about there. And I think if anyone can find out about it, it'd be Andrew. So go, Andrew. Go to Willis, and we'll see what develops there. Or did we need to go to that other place that they say they have really great iron and bring some of that back so that we can do something? I'm not quite sure. But I like the music. Hero shield. Silver sword. I can't do anything with a thing with that. Aw. Can't do a thing with that. Hero armor? Can't do a thing with that. Aw, but... Well, that's a shame. I was hoping you could do something with the stuff I have. Well, maybe if I buy a weapon, you can temper that. Okay, well, I was eyeing one of them arbalists. I was eyeing the arbalist. So, I'm not gonna come away empty-handed. We'll buy an arbalist. Alright. And we'll see if you can temper an arbalist. Is that so crazy? Arbalist. Can't do a thing with that. Oh, but I bought it just here. Okay, well. Once again, clearly I'm having a misconception of some sort. But that's okay, I'm just trying to figure things out on my own. We'll just end the search, and we'll advance. And I'm sure I'll figure some things out in the future. Hopefully. Anyways, yes, advance, I say. Alright, so. Dispatch guards to this region. It'll be... What do I want to bring? You've got some water. I guess Hydras could potentially hop off. It looks like there's a slim area of water that I can take advantage of. Certainly Hydras will be useful in this one. I think I'm going to keep my Hydras today. Yeah, I think I can actually use them. We'll try. Okay, so the people I'm not going to send with keep with me are, Zod, the dog. No, let's send a lot of our dogs. How about that? As much as I like them. Oh, wax, that's... Well, I'll send one Hydra, because I'm not completely sure if the Hydras are working. So yeah, I'll take one Hydra, and I'm going to dispatch a bunch of dogs, and maybe a few of my liches. Lich, and... a bunch of ghosts and dogs. That'll be good. Alright, very good. Advance to the next battle. And, yeah, that sounds good. All right. Subaltric. I guess it's South Baltric. Ah, I can see our home. Low. All is Loa. Oh, is this Loa? All is going to... It's the way he trailed off. I thought it wasn't saying the whole word. All is going according to my cunning plan. We must have a feast tonight to celebrate. Her blood shall make a fine first course. Or who? I think I accidentally skipped over that. Sabrina or Susan or someone's... I kind of wish I hadn't accidentally skipped over that. Whoopsie doodle. Oh well, it's fine. So is there a path for the Hydra? Yeah, I can kind of skirt along that edge. It's gonna have to go over a fair amount of land to get to it. Yeah, there's the Griffin Cave. Okay, there's the Griffin Cave that was spoken about so much. In the back, we want our flyers. Oh, whoops, I accidentally deployed on all my castle spots. Okay, well, that was a mistake, but at least it makes things a bit faster on the first turn. And I'll just throw out a Blade Storm like I usually do. There we go. And the turn is over. Looks like the enemy actually has some very decent forces today. They're all pretty high level from the start. And he's summoning some good ones, so... with our reduced numbers, we're actually in for quite a fight today. Well, that'll be good experience for the people we did bring along. And I'm sure we'll do just fine. Alright, so Henry, get over to the water as quickly as you can. Flyers will move up. And actually, while I'm thinking about it before I do anything else... Oh, right, actually. Yeah, we want to deploy first. Yeah, then. Then move. But we just don't want to deploy on the castle squares. So I was thinking about doing it early just so I don't forget, but that would also kind of mess up the point of the whole exercise. And of course, Spock likes to turn people into goats. Because Spock just does that, and he gets a level for doing so, who can blame him? The people who got turned into goats? Well, yeah, they can, certainly, but everyone else who's watching certainly understands how entertaining this is. you gotta support his goating habit. Okay, flyers in the back. Take a step forward so that I can thrust my troops out there more easily. Throw a Blade Storm at a Skeletal Knight, doing decent damage, one must say. Or I might say, throw Bobbit the Hobbit out there. And Zod, the Dragon God. Gimli the Berserker, or Warlord Berserker. And... No, you're not going to the front. I guess, Ted. Ted deserves to go in front because he doesn't get enough action these days. And then Spot. Okay, that's a good turn. I'll have to watch over my previous videos to give me some hints about what to do with the whole Sabrina quest. Because I think there was a lot of hints that I'm just having trouble remembering when it comes down to it, but that's okay. Just enjoy the game, and I can always deal with the quests in the future. So, you're still a goat. That's entirely my fault. And I'm happy about it. And for that, I'm perfectly fine with that, apparently. Now, manticores are good at skeletons. Make that happen. Let's see, is there... I got another manticore back here, Bob. Can you reach any skeletons? Not at the moment. You can only reach the dog. Okay, so if we can do something to that dog... We can do a double lightning bolt. It's not bad. Or just a volcano. Right, Cerberi, they tend to be tough against the fire magic. Okay, But Spock, you can't do anything from over here, can you? Oh, you can ice storm quite far away. Okay, then go ahead and do that, and this manticore will come around here, hit the skeleton warrior for the 100. That's very good. And then you do the ice storm and a lovely area of these 5 individuals. I think that's a pretty good ratio and quite good damage. Very nice. Skeleton warrior destroyed. So a lot more experience for Spock. Ted is a bit slow. Gimli can't reach anyone but can fortify Susan and her location. My dragon, of course, also being a bit slow, but a priority to move just so he can be sure to get a good position. Bobbitts, once again, can't hit anyone. Good movement, though. He'll get up there. My hound here, my Cerberus, is just going to get into a dog fight. I know we're getting a counterattacked upon, but the opponent has very little health, so that'll allow Bob to move in and finish him.
Finish him!
As the Mortal Kombat game likes to say, which is still a relevant quote all these years later, but that is, I realize how old of a quote that is. It's like, that quote is actually almost used up its welcome, one might say. But not quite, it's a classic. Alright, we'll throw some freezes at the Skeleton Warrior. Although maybe I should have thrown that at the Hounds, I'm not sure actually now. Well, we've softened him up and Santacor can try to knock him down. Not quite, but we're real close. And now, Amon. Well, first, he'll deploy some troops. Should I have deployed that one there? Ah, who cares. You there, Santacor here. Hound there. Rodney should have come out earlier, really. And that should be everyone. I should be able to put out just about everyone on this turn, once I'm done here. Can we kill this one with a Bladestorm? Yes! Amon has defeated an opponent with a Bladestorm. Wonderful! I have dispatched an opponent with my own power. I could have placed that guy in a slightly better spot, but only slightly. It's never a deal. Alright, so that takes care of the placement of all my troops. Very nice. Oh, one last person to move. Henry has almost made it to his home. Working his way there. Kind of annoying for him to have to do that. Glad I only took one of my 2 Hydras. Still, incredible hit points, so glad I have it. And he makes a great guard, so definitely not complaining when it comes to my Hydras. But I really love my flyers. My flyers are extremely convenient, I must say. One might say, and I do say, hooray. Alright, so physical actually isn't that bad of an idea against a ghost because he doesn't counterattack. Alright, so I slam that ghost up and down the coast. Let's see if we got somebody who can easily dispatch him. Guess we'll just get one of our manticores on that. You missed! Really? Do we have a manticore that's further back? Well, yeah, but not one that can reach. The furthest back manticore can only go back, or reach up to here, so. Yeah, we'll have to use one of these closer ones. Even though I was hoping to use them for further up maneuvers, we want to keep... This bridge is a choke point, and we want to keep things moving along, so. We're going to need some artillery support, as it were. So Susan's going to move up. She can launch spells from a distance. So that'll be an asset. Spock, same deal. Too bad you can't get closer. But you can morph someone if you want. Oh, I did say that I was going to keep doing this just for fun. But I kind of wish that... Or no, had you moved? I guess you've moved. Well, Jinja, you're going to become a goat. Because I'd rather turn a manticore into a goat than Gimli into a goat at this point. Although I'm not sure why. Alright, and now we're up against a dog. Okay. Well, Spot can move up and potentially paralyze or bite Just fights. Get into a dog fight. You don't take much damage. And that way we won't get counterattacked upon when we continue to attack here. Very good damage there. Alright, now Betty, go ahead and move in for the finisher. I'm okay with you doing that. A freeze should do it. Very nice. Although if you missed with that freeze, you could have got paralyzed there, so maybe that wasn't the most advisable action. Oh well, it worked out. All is a well that ends well. Alright, so... I guess then... We do have a hole here that I guess we might as well plug up before they plug up this hole with their troops and cutting off our advance. So yeah, we'll go ahead and do that. Although maybe I shouldn't have attacked with Santacor there, because he is kind of hurt. Well, let's move up our Harpy here, who will take off some of the pressure so that he can't be multiple attacked. Sounds good. Druid, move up wherever you like. Can you heal a goat back to human form? No, you cannot. Okay. Well, this is not like the movie Willow, where you can turn people into other shapes. Or you are not like Willow, where you can turn that lady into a goat and then turn her back from a goat and whatnot. It was a funny scene. It was the funny polymorphing scene from Willow. Well, Willow was a funny movie. That was a good movie. In fact, I wouldn't mind watching that movie again. It's been so long that actually it's, yeah. It's a good one. And I'm a really big fan of Steve Warwick. So, I generally like everything he's in. But Willow was a particularly good movie, I must say. It's a lot of funny lines and interesting environments. I mean, not everything was perfect about that movie, admittedly. But it was quite good. Alright. So, am I moving a bit faster? I think I'm moving a bit faster. That's pretty cool, if I am. If I got my leader moving a bit faster than before. Let's throw out a blade storm and keep progress moving forward. And Henry has taken to the seas. He's fishing the lovely seas. Karmak uses Mega Restore. Erupt, okay. That didn't hurt much, so I'm okay with that. And it looks like the enemies actually opened up a little bit of a gap there. Good. I was worried that we're gonna... No. Well, sort of. No, they did. They totally choke pointed me. Okay, I was worried that they would choke point me, but I was hoping that they would decide against it for some reason, but that's not the case. However, they only have some basic wraiths here, so I feel like I can overpower them. If I do things right. Bob, can you rip one of them apart? You missed! Santacor, can you rip one of them apart? 90. Not quite. So close. Okay, Ranticore, how about you? How much damage will you do this? Because I remember one of them doing like 100 to a... Okay, so I thought one of my guys did like 100 to a wraith earlier. But that's not the case. Or like a lich or something. One of those wraith archetypes. That's fine. Yeah, we're taking them out. We're bombarding them from behind and taking them out. Clearing out the enemy lines. Very good. Gimli. Sure, you can do a lot of damage. Not quite murdering him, but we're pretty close. Pretty close. Alright. And the path is, for the most part, open to us. Especially if we can paralyze one of these bastards. Yes! Paralyzation successful! Alright, our path is open. Well, or no, your threat radius is still getting in the way. Maybe I can just kind of blow the man down. Go. Yeah, go. Where'd you go? Where did we teleport him to? We teleported him kind of far. If we teleported him into the ocean with you, Okay, well, that's a convenient... I like the pushing spell a bit more than I used to, that's for sure. And now, you are a goat dog. Nope, okay. Not a goat dog. I was hoping to have a goat dog. Goat dog. Oh, alright, well... We can still sing a goat dog song, but we don't have a dog from a goat. Not just yet. But we will. So, there's a particular time I'm supposed to go to the Griffin Cave, right? I am a druid. I am at one with nature. Please do not eat me, Mr. Griffin. You didn't find anything. For it is not the right time for this. But I figured we're all bunched up anyways. Alright, was it... This is the morning. Is it the afternoon? Was it... I forget the time of day. I kind of forget what they said about griffins. But I believe it pertain... Excuse me, hiccups. I believe it pertained to a particular time of day. I forget what they say about the griffins. Alright, well, Amon gets first position. Oh, you can... Apparently a Amon can fly, slightly. Was that always the case? I get some sort of item for that. Well, that works. Fine. I'll hit the warlock. Just because I'm having trouble targeting the one I actually want to target, but that's fine. Whatever. Henry. Come this way, my friend. Or should I be... Oh, we have another... We have another bit to go around, so actually kind of took the corner a bit close there. Alright, minor inefficiency there. No big deal. Get the hounds to move up. Guess I don't have to worry too much about moving everyone else since they're going to get tied up anyways, but... Eh, what the heck. Well, it'll help getting a bit closer, I suppose. So there we go. That's the last of them. Rodney treats a goat. Because Rodney knows how to treat a goat right. And now he is back. Karmak restores the Death Dragon. Fair enough. As long as the Death Dragon does not get to act this round, I'm okay with it. What about that other one we blew off? Well, he's coming, but he's having to go through the water, and that's kind of slow for him. So, well, that bought us a lot of time, that's for sure. Alright, we'll be able to advance. We'll be able to advance through this choke point, this bottleneck here. And that's good. Can you morph him? Well, you could. Or you could just hit him with something powerful. Go! Well, no. We want Spock to be moving up as fast as he can. So, yeah, go ahead and move up, Spock. You're just that powerful that I want you moving forward at all times. It'll be more convenient for other people to attack that dragon. Same with you, Susan. Keep moving forward. We don't want to increase congestion any more than we need to. I, Amon, will step forward and cast the Blade Storm on my foes. Fine, I'll just hit this guy. The dragon is injured. And now we'll work from the back. You can move up here. Sure. And you move up here. Of course, yeah, we're gonna have to move some of the people at the front so we can move the people at the back, so it's getting a little bit complicated. Alright, so we want the toughest Manticore to go first. You take the hits. Very good. Level up. 2 and 2. Fair enough. Not huge growth, but it's stable. It's good, I would say. It's good enough. Nothing to sneeze at. Alright. Manticore, you're probably going to take some attacks. Get on this bottom side. You're feeling healthy. So yeah, you can absorb the blows from the enemy on their turn. Santacore, you're feeling kind of weak, so you want to be protected between your friends. And we've... Despite the fact that we didn't do a lot of damage on each attack, the sheer number of our assaults... The sheer numbers we are assaulting that dragon with has overcome him pretty well. Take that, Death Worm. Very good. And harpy can move up. The harpy can strike the Cerberus if she wishes. I think she would prefer to stay up on a cliff where she feels a bit safe. Now, Gimli, well, I would like to re-paralyze. I would like to re-paralyze the dragon, and it would be really convenient to do that with a ghost, like folks here. So go ahead. Paralyze is used. Death Dragon is paralyzed. Hooray! All right. Now, Gimli, you're quite good at slaying dragons. I will let you take a little bit of time to do that. It's actually not high as damage as I was hoping for. Can you shoot anything from there? Yes, you can shoot the dragon. Yes. I forgot you have quite long range with that wind shot. Alright. The hound will bite with triple. How could you miss with three heads? I've asked this question before, and I will ask it again. How can you miss when you have three heads? Nice. Zod got the kill. He showed him who's the superior dragon when one of us is paralyzed and heavily injured. Yeah, that's showing him. It's a victory he'll take, though. Congo, getting with the rest of my wonderful air force. Jinja, form up with the squadron. The hound joining the wolf pack. Mong, the mongrel, taking up the rear. Rodney, also a bit slow, but he can revive people, probably. I'm not quite sure how that works, though, still. But it probably has to be used the very turn somebody dies, which is something I failed to do last time, I believe. Anyways, and Henry, can't forget about him, slowly working his way along the sea. Seashore. Okay. We're done. This battle so far is not taking as long as I expected it to. However, I'm sure it will be a fair... I'm sure this battle will take a fair amount of time because, well, the opposition is quite tough. And if they're going to pull more paralysis shenanigans like that, and the fact that I just don't have as many troops as I usually do, yeah, I'm sure that will add up to a fair amount of delays. Anyways, move as far as we can, troops. Let's work from the back. Go ahead and heal Amon if you wish. If you so desire, you can tend to my non-existent wounds. Alright then. This hound is not close enough to participate. Just get as close as you can. Same with you, my ghostly friends. Oh, can you get to that dragon? He's finally coming back. Oh, you came crawling back now, did you? We'll see about that. And you're paralyzed. Ooh, it's a haunting reminder of the scary reality of life and death. It's a haunting reminder of death and its inevitability. Particularly in your case. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and paralyze this skeleton because I can. Very good. Now I could just take him out with a bunch of manticores. Let's evaluate that option. Well, volcanoes tend not to work so well in these people. Fire tends to work better. Burn! Burn the lich! Right, that is an area attack, but fortunately my Cerberus is pretty tough against that sort of thing. And more experience for Susan, I suppose. But I forgot the nature of that particular spell. That one was a new one to me, or not. You're not feeling so well, are you? Oh, 124, you're, I guess, acceptable. Getting kind of scary for that one, still. Alright. Hound moves up. Move up Jinja. Go ahead and back attack that skeleton there. Good. Okay, so who can Spock reach? Spock can get down here and reach this lich. And despite the fact that they're tough against Earth, he is the Earth Spirit, so You know what? Go for it. Just fire it off anyways. The Grey Lich only took 58 damage. Okay, well, that was a misconception. The ghosts are very tough against Earth attacks. Because that is probably one of the best Earth spells, and still quite tough. Okay. Go ahead and bash on this skeleton. Should be fine. Reinforcements on the way. Although, actually, it might not be okay. They do have a lot of troops in that area that could move in and counterattack the next turn. A lot of wizards, a lot of magic users that can bombard. A little bit scary. Also, we're failing to hit a lot. Of course, we hit just there, but still, I could be hitting more. Thank you. That's more like it. Okay. He's taken out. Anyone else within range for attacking on this area? Yeah, the archer is. We won't worry about the skeleton as much as we'll worry about either. Yeah, the druid would be a nice thing to shoot. Let's just shoot the druid instead. I was thinking about shooting the lich. Actually, maybe I should have shot the lich. I'm not sure which target would have yielded more damage, but I'm starting to think I should have shot the lich. Okay, so Betty's gonna come up and smack the druid again, because that's the only one that won't counterattack around here. Bob is going to... Wait, did the ghost... Yeah, the ghost didn't count as a physical. It's like, either it counted as a ranged or a physical. But no, he's got no physical, so let's go ahead and whack him with the physical, because he won't get a counterattack. You almost got him. I think I know who I'm going to finish off with a blade storm in a moment. I am unleash a blade storm of epic proportions upon thee. I can target correctly. How do you aim this? There we go. How do you aim this thing? Bazango! Hard to hit enemies close by. Alright. And that ends the turn. Paralyze is used. Alright, the Cerberuses are getting a little annoying with my harpies. Paralysis is not fun. Was that Mega Paralyze? Well, it didn't work. Meteor Strike. Ow. Metamorph. If anyone's resistant to that sort of thing, would be my particular Manticores, because they've just been metamorphosized or mutated or polymorphed just so many times that they've developed a resistance, I would say. Alright, well, it's a shame that Betty got paralyzed with full health, but at least she's not in any danger of dying soon. Alright, so skeleton warriors do not like fighting towns. They don't mind fighting each other. And Ted, class increased! Congratulations, it's about time. You're a skeleton warrior! Hooray! Okay, so I think you were pretty good against dogs. That's actually okay. Well, you gain a level anyways. Congratulations, Ghibli. Attack power by 5. I like to see the great attack power generation. Gains. Okay, so Susan, go ahead and throw out some lightning bolts, I suppose. You can just do 1, 2... There you go. How does that do against them? That does okay, I suppose. Not the greatest, but not the worst. Spock, you can destroy that druid, I guess. Or you can go into the town, but I think you should destroy the druid with... Actually, that's a bit of an overkill, I just realized. Okay, well, whoops. Yeah, no, that was a bit unnecessary use of Spock there. That's okay. Alright, well, he got a level. Maybe not. What I do know is that this druid will attack this Cerberus with whatever melee weapon he has. Actually, that was not a good idea either. Okay, well, Rodney... Well, Zod will come up and give this hound his comeuppance with a normal strike. Okay, you missed. So much for them comeuppance. then Thost the Ghost will try to paralyze this one. Paralyze is used. Oh, you get paralyzed. Yeah, you counterattack with paralyze. I forgot. It was that attack type. Whoopsie doodle. Okay. So we're getting a lot of our friends paralyzed. That's a shame. Let's see. I'll just keep moving forward. I guess, now which one counterattacked? It was the one... Yeah, this one has not counterattacked, so you go ahead. Or no, you have counterattacked this turn. Okay, so I could have tried to paralyze him, but... Oh well, the melee on these guys is pretty good, and I don't know who else to use, so just do it. You need to use melee eventually anyways to kill your opponent. So if you're going to do it anyways, you might as well lead off with it. Or if you're going to actually kill the opponent on that turn, there's no need to bother paralyzing first, I'd say. Okay, we'll just go ahead and bite. Fight and fight. And fight and fight. And you can take out this guy. Hopefully. Nice. Very good. All is going according to plan. Level up. Alright, as far as this skeleton's concerned... Well... See, well, Rodney, why don't you slap that death worm? That's a good experience for you. Kind of risky. All right, and Henry is arriving just at the time to join the rest of the brouhaha here at the enemy's lair. I guess, yeah, just the Jinja, you have the most health. Take the front and take the brunt of the damage from the Skeleton Warrior. Shouldn't be too bad, actually. It wasn't too bad. Okay, and Manticore. Yeah, you can just stay where you are. We're just gonna gather up and do a beat down on the Skeleton. And you definitely want to do a hit on this one, because you're so hurt that you don't want to fight anyone else. Congo is the same sort of thing, or maybe you should just rest. I'm really not sure. Actually, you can't even move properly. Well, it's just because there's this dog here, actually. But the dog has already fought this turn, so yeah, you're going to move here. And the other Manticore is going to move over there to do his attack. And maybe we can find a way to cover you. Okay, well, you can defeat an enemy. Level up. Maybe that'll give you enough health to survive the attacks that are going to hit you. Maybe not. Maybe a Mon should heal you. Or maybe a Mon should just continue attacking. We'll decide. Or maybe a Mon should step in the way of anyone who would attack my dear minion. And I guess just fortify myself with a Night Shield, because I might be coming under the brunt of some attacks being here. Alright, yeah, sure. Night Shield! Come get me, you weaklings. I've got 305 health and some pretty good defense, so we'll see. We'll see how this works out. A little bit worried about my tactic here. Ouchie! 17 points of damage, that's not so bad. Metamorph, how dare you! I will not change into anything but something greater! A greater vampire, okay? Another spell on me, more experience. Another spell on me, more experience. Paralyze is used, but that doesn't happen to me. Amon gains a level! I just become more powerful the more you try to strike me down. Yeah, they really tried though, but they didn't deal that much damage. Betty level up from being attacked. Alright. Well, that didn't work out so well. Okay. Don't lock up on me now, game. Okay, that's one of those signs where we... that's one of those times where we should change the state very carefully. Hit F5. And we save the state. Okay. So I am going to... Yeah, I didn't lose that much health. I'm going to melt the frickin' earth out from underneath you. Right here. Boom. Alright, 7 opponents hit. Delicious experience. So much delicious experience. Okay. Spock wants to move up, but for that to happen, we're gonna need to do a little bit of rearranging. So Henry can come ashore. Henry adores attacking humans. Of course, that human was just about dead, so actually, someone else could have done that without fear. But that's fine. Spock still can't get a good position just yet from that. Why Gimli's gonna come up, and although he doesn't deal... Who deals good damage against the dogs? Well, Susan can move up here if she wants. Or... Well, Gimli's good against the dragons, so Gimli's gonna whack this dragon. I'm pretty sure he does great damage against that. Yeah, that's pretty darn good. Ted will also assist in this endeavor. Alright, well that's just okay damage. Zod, I guess Zod will move up and take the brunt of the damage on this attack against the Cerberus. That way, now Spock can't get in unless we kill this opponent, so. Alright, I do want to kill this dog, though. I do want to kill this dog this turn, so let's make that happen. Who has the most health between you guys? It would be Jinja. Jinja steps up here and bites there, and the dog is nearly dead, so close to being dead, that Bob can just do the finisher and it's okay? Yes, okay, that's fine. Now Spock will move up and be in a great position to continue bombardment next turn. He will summon the Earth Spirit to strike the Skeleton Warrior because I think that's effective, right? Or is it just not undead? Nope, that's pretty effective. And then, we're gonna have you come around here and maybe strike the human, the Black Bishop. Although that could get painful. No, it was okay. It was okay. Well, it's pretty painful, but it's alright still. Right, I wanna create a spot here, so Bakongo is gonna have to come out. Congo will come out, and... But Congo, just come around here. You're not going to be able to attack this turn. Now, Bobbit can come up, just right up here and shoot whoever he likes. He can shoot this druid dead. No, he can't. He can try to, though. He can certainly try. The Hound will continue the dog fight. Rawr! Okay, that was not the plan with the dog fights. I guess I'll just heal you. There you go, heal. And Faust, the ghost, will try to paralyze this deathworm. Nice. Very nice. Yeah, we should try to do more paralyzing. I feel like I haven't been using my paralyze enough. Of course, I just paralyzed when it was just about dead. Oh well, now Susan can move up without being affected by that. But radius, I suppose. Rantacore. Yeah, finish it off. You won't get counterattacked now. I don't think you were going to get counterattacked. Well, finish it off. Just wasn't thinking straight there. And Susan can move up here. And then blast you with the volcano, even though you're tough against it. It's my only single hitter spell that I have available right now, because the lightning isn't good enough. Or it's the best single hitter I've got, I should say. And I guess, yeah, continue with the dog fight, since you don't have many other options at the moment. And while you're so healthy, I do want to get you involved, so yeah, you come around here. And now Rodney continues to whack a death worm by himself. It's working out for him, though. Level increased. You learn Zap. Okay, you might want to start casting that, then. And now my Harpy will flap around and strike. Go ahead and strike the wizard. Necroman. Strike the Necroman. Keep him from doing his Necroman stuff. Karmak uses magic hellfire. You you hit your own people a little bit there, actually, so I'm okay with that. And you struck one of my toughest people. So, sure. You're trying to paralyze Amon. I'm not even sure if this can happen. I don't think it can happen, actually. Because I haven't seen any status effects affect my leader yet. Okay, I will melt the very earth, and I'm gonna do it here so I can whack Karmak. I got one person. Oh, it was the druid. I got the druid. Okay, the druid is dead. And then you can do an ice storm. Of course, it's a shame that I cut a hole in that, but ice storm here. We're sieging him with area strikes. It'll be over soon. It's usually really bad for the enemy once we start sieging them. And then let's do some lightning bolts here. Lightning bolts. Lightning bolts. Very nice. Susan leveled up. Alright, I love to use Gimli early on. And it is fun to chop down a necromancer. It is not fun to miss. Alright. Oh, you can do it. There we go. And it was kind of overkill, too. That's a shame. It was overkill, and I missed to boot. So, whoops. Alright, no big deal. We're winning anyway, so no worries. But Congo, you can strike now. Almost. Henry, you can finish off that opponent. I'm okay with this. Congratulations, Henry. Alright. Zod can move up here and strike the skeleton warrior. No, because you guys can take the damage from that. It's just a skeleton warrior. He doesn't deal that much damage, so yeah, go ahead and strike. You guys are designed for that. The big cats are great at dismantling the skeletons. I don't know why, but they just are. It doesn't seem like a manticore would be great at skeletons, since one of their big tricks is poisoning and slashing and clawing damage. And I would figure without flesh, both of those sort of attacks would be less effective. But, why do I know? I mean, they're big lions, they can crush bone, and they're probably still pretty good at skeletons in one form or another. But, I don't know, when I imagine that combat, it seems like it would be an okay, but it wouldn't be like a critical weakness. I don't quite understand the logic that makes them strong against skeletons in particular. But I've said it before and I'll say it again. Video game logic does not need to make sense. It just needs to be fun. But it's fun to explore the potential ways to explain it, because oftentimes, I mean, they do have proper reasons for things that kind of explain stuff. Not always. Clearly, that is far from a rule. Very good. And it's kind of scary for a skeleton warrior to fight a dog. So I guess it's fine that you have to avoid him, but it is a little too bad as well. You want some experience. Rodney is using Zap, and that got him the same amount of experience, but you're doing more damage at least. Now he must defeat the enemy Cerberus. It's not an easy dog fight, but we are winning. Alright, and it's Bobbit's turn. He will shoot the Death Worm. Nice! I wasn't thinking he would kill that one. It's nice to get a positive surprise every once in a while. Alright, that's not much damage. Pekongo, it didn't hurt Henry nearly as much as it hurt Pekongo, especially when you think about percentages of health. Alright, so if I melt the earth now, can I reach Karmak? No, I cannot. I can only reach that square, which being that square is a problem because Spock is there. Alright, well, Spock, go ahead and do your ice storm for starters, because that's in the perfect spot. You are in the perfect spot for that. Fire away. Nice. Now, if this manticore were to move, I could throw the melt earth where that particular wizard is. The necromancer. I could fire at the necromancer. The necroman. But let's see. Okay, yeah, you just murdered him. You scared him to death. I wasn't paying attention to the health bubbles. So, Gimli, that skeletal warrior's at 3 health. So we can just eliminate him. Done. I was just a little bit worried about this guy's health. This manticore's health. So I wanted to strike. Yeah, I want to strike an opponent that is paralyzed, like the stepworm of this guy. So you can't get killed. Now you, run that necromancer through. Nice. Or cleave him in twain, or however you want to put it. Okay, so now. Oh, right. I wasn't thinking about my Melt Earth spell. I guess the Melt Earth will either hit my friends. How are you feeling, Gimli? Or I could just move this turn. Maybe I should just move this turn and use my abilities next turn. That would be another option, certainly. Alright, so, Henry, why don't you move in there and take the brunt of the blow from Karmak? You can do it. Okay, you missed, but you still took the brunt of a blow. And you're saving a spot that can't be... people can't come back on. Congo is messed up. Bob isn't feeling so bad. Bob, strike to death. Alright, you've taken a hit. You've gained a level. Congratulations on that. But Congo, you can follow up, but you're feeling very, very, very badly. Alright, and now just one more punch from... or one more bite from Jinja. Nope, not quite. Dang it. Come on now. Alright, well, we're gonna finish off this hound up here. Arr. Your days are numbered. We'll let the druid finish him off. Oops. Not there. Pressing the button too fast. Alright, spot. Guess you can re-paralyze this sucker, because he's come back to life. Or not, or you could screw that up, but at least he's attacked, and now Rodney is safe. Well, kind of. Rodney could get killed, but keep it up, Rodney. You need the experience. And your life depends on the experience, or you should get experience like your life depends on it. Just keep it up. Harpy... Ted. How about Ted? Ted moves up, and Ted can take a swing at Karmak. Not the greatest damage, but good for you. Okay. And Susan can continue to bombard with the... Oh, Thunderstorms. Thunderstorm now? Interesting. Still 2 targets, but more damage? Or was that the... Yeah, you had Lightning Bolt before, so that's slightly more damage. Nice. Okay. Zod can finish this one off. Or I do kind of want to move up with Zod, but too late now. Zod, level increased. Congratulations. And Mong can... Well, can I move more freely now? Well, a bit, but not a lot. Yeah, just move up here. Amon. And now I will Bladestorm. Whatever, yeah, just Bladestorm that. I will Bladestorm that thing over there. Okay. Finished him off. I guess that saves Rodney some trouble. They can join the fight. Bobbitt will continue to assault Karmak. Mong. The mongrel will bite Deathworm, I suppose. Since I don't think the dog over there has counterattacked. And same with you, Harpy, because anyone else you attack will counterattack you? Is that the case? Yeah, the hounds will counterattack you, so you just go ahead and freeze the paralyzed opponents. And yeah, just go ahead and gnaw on that druid's leg for a while. Okay, done. Your turn is over. Oh, still being aggressive, huh? Hitting me with hellfire, are you? Only 3 points of damage. Although, I do worry about Jinja there. No, I think Jinja's okay. Oh, and that's your turn, huh? Well, that was a very quick turn that you just had there. Okay, so I'm gonna melt Earth even though I am hitting my friends. Kind of a shame, but you can't make an omelet without blasting your friends. Apparently. I'm on! Level increased for shooting his friends! That is what I do. And, well, Spock, would you like to follow suit? I know you're hitting two of your friends and three of your opponents, but one of them's the enemy leader, and, well, Henry and Ted are tough-ish. Getting a little bit worried about Ted, though. Actually, they're both not feeling so great. Okay, so, yeah, go ahead and hit Karmak again. Karmak counterattacks for 100 points of damage. A bit concerning there. Alright, we'll keep pounding him. Alright, Faust the Ghost has defeated another enemy and opened up another slot for attack. Gimli will move in and attack Karmak hard. Slam, 119. Getting close. Bob being one of the more healthy of mine. Manticore moves in and misses. Oh, how could you betray me? So, all right. Jinja has taken out a Cerberus, giving us another space to attack from, but Kongo feels very awkward as he steps up and takes a swack at the enemy leader. He successfully hit him, but it doesn't look like we'll be taking out the enemy leader just this turn. You're going to hit a Skeleton Warrior because you're so good at it. Now, Santicore, not feeling so great, he'll just attack this one. Congratulations on the level there. Alright, our hounds are moving up. Trying to catch up. Just re-paralyze that guy. Congratulations. Spot needs to catch up. And Rodney's left out in the cold for now. Mong, the mongrel, will just dogfight this other Cerberus. That's fine. And then Susan, keep using your new thunderstorm spell to great effect. Zappy zap. Or, well, decent effect. It's not the greatest effect. Good enough, good enough. Ride up and attack this Cerberus again. And finally, my harpy will take it out. Alright. The enemy leader? His days are numbered. He will lose his life very shortly. But first, we need to move our druid here. Go ahead and heal whoever you like. And Bobbit will once again assault Karmak. Or should you take out the Black Bishop? Or not, the Black Bishop is a tricky fellow. Ooh, very evasive, you. And treat yourself to a nice day, Rodney. Alright. Karmak uses Hellfire. Okay, well then Karmak is screwed. Karmak is done. It's game over for Karmak. We might lose one of our troops, but it's definitely game over for Karmak. Zod is paralyzed. That's fine, because it's over for Karmak. Okay, well, you use Restore. That's going to hurt, or that's going to make things a little bit more difficult, but yeah, it's not at all, it doesn't heal all your life, so game over for Karmak. Game over for you. It's done. Stick a fork in Karmak. He is done. And I'm not going to take any extra time. Let's do this. Gimli? Cleave him in twain! No? Okay, Ted, would you like to do the honors? Nope, because you're not powerful enough. Bob? Can you do it? Yes, you can. No, damn, you can't. Okay, well then I am on. Well, no, maybe we should give this to someone. Bobbit, you can have it. You can have it. Go ahead. Fine, fine. Then I am on. We'll do this with the Blade Storm. For I am the only one who gets to defeat Karmak. You have been bested. What? I missed? Did it? Can it miss? Oh, or maybe I can't take him out at this point without a certain thing. Is this a point where I need a certain element or something to take this opponent out? Well, we'll find out. Huh, it's interesting that he stayed alive with one hit point. I can't kill him right now. Okay, so I need one of the spirits to kill him. This is the first time I've ran into this issue. Okay, then. Well, I seem to have used up some of my time here excessively. Alright, so I think there was the wind shrine nearby. Or no, the water shrine nearby I need to figure out the quest for. Okay. Well, it isn't in this zone, is it? Alright, well. In any case, I'm gonna have to figure out this whole water spirit thing. I guess I might have to retreat. I'm not used to this. It doesn't let me kill him. I managed to kill the other elements before I... or the other leaders before I got the elements, right? Or do I just need to kill him with an ice spell? Could be. Well, the harpies certainly have ice. That'd be one way to do it. Freeze is used, but no, that doesn't kill him. Okay, well, I may have messed up in more ways than one this time. That's fine. I'll get it sorted out. But there certainly are one or two quests I need to complete in the coming episode. I might be forced to retreat. We'll see. Okay, level up. I guess that's maybe why he's not bothering to Mega Restore. He knows he doesn't need it. Is that the case? Okay, my turn is over. Karmak uses Mega Restore. Well, he's certainly Mega Restoring now. Alright, well, let's try to bring him back down. Karmak counterattacks. That hurts. Ghibli strikes. 100 damage. Ted strikes, Ted misses, Harpy freezes, I hit him with the Blade Storm, I'm gonna have Spock try to finish him off with the Ice Storm if I can manage it. Okay, we attacked with him with everyone nearby. I need to get Susan up here so she can start bombarding. Okay, everyone get out of Susan's way. You can go ahead attack that druid. That'd be fine. So, well, that's as far as Susan can move. Okay, so we got Karmak down to 300. Can do like a firestorm or an ice storm. I guess we'll do the firestorm for now, just because that's the only single hitter I have, and I don't want to mess up my troops so much or too much. He's probably gonna end up healing himself again. Heal, I guess you. And you can rest. And yada yada. Good enough. All right, your turn is over. Karmak mega restores himself again. Stop being so difficult, Karmak. Alright, well, I guess we need to injure him a lot, but not enough where he'll heal like that. Or we just need to kill him outright. One of the two. Alright, well, I'm gonna mega restore my Hydra there, Henry. What deals him good damage? Well, the freeze isn't working out because you're not hitting. Spock. Maybe we can get Spock close enough where he's doing his Earth Spirit. Congo's at 5 health. Congo's gonna die if I don't do something about him. Spock, get close enough to hit him with your Earth Elemental to deal more damage. Of course, then when you do your Ice, you're gonna do it all around you. Still, that's quite good damage. Okay, well, we got Spock another level. If nothing else, we're getting a lot of good experience from this. Dude, I might be injuring him too much where he'll Mega Restore again. 333. He's probably just gonna mega restore again, but we'll see. We'll see what he do. Hellfire. Okay, nice. I mean, kinda. Ow. Bob, it died. No. That's actually gonna make things more difficult to kill Karmak, but considering you're injured like that. Okay, so Spock. Okay, yeah, we wanna finish him off with the ice, so yeah, First we move back Pekongo, because he's nearly dead. Then we move up Henry and have him strike and take the brunt of the blow. Fair enough. Then Gimli smacks him a really good one. Ted doesn't do much damage, so he'll step back and let in, say, Zod. Well, okay, then the Harpy will move aside. Blast here. You missed. Stop missing so much. This is essential that you don't miss right now. Zod moves in. He's very tough. That doesn't do the greatest damage, though. Okay, and I guess Volcano Karmak. Bang. 51 points of damage. We're getting really close. A new attack. 33 points of damage. So 58. Then I do the Blade Storm. Nearly finishing him off. 19 points. Okay, well, that's everything we can throw at him besides the Ice Storm, so go ahead and do the Ice Storm, even though it's going to hit around you and be painful to us as well. Okay, so... Ow. Ow. Ouchie. Karmak, 38. You took 38 points of damage? How much was that? You're down to 1. Okay, so I think we've reached the point where Karmak is invincible. I haven't dealt with this scenario before. He'll just mega restore himself forever. Whoops. Okay. Well, is there an answer to this nearby? Guess we might as well check it out, but yeah, this is the first time I've ran into that issue as well. Guess we might have to retreat. Hestia, can I help you? We kept a stone called the Sunstone at our church. It was one of our holy relics. The Sunstone of Hestia and the Moonstone of Loa were linked to one to the other. But one day, the mayor of Loa came and took the Sunstone. I hope nothing happens to it. Okay, what do you have to say there? The people living in Loa are very strange. They only come out at night. Their church is strange, too. Something is definitely wrong there. Ah, okay. That's why my leader referred to it as home. Ale is a source of life. It is one of my supreme joys. Come now, have a pint. There are supposed to be griffin's nests in the mountains near here. Once in a while, they come down to feed on the livestock. Darn varmints. Sound like more than varmints. You're lucky to be alive. It's lucky they're just only taking livestock. That they're not more indiscriminate. Right, we already talked to you. I wonder why everyone sleeps during the day. So everyone sleeps during the day in this town? Okay, well, whatever. Alrighty then. I missed the water shrine. That much is clear. I need to complete the water quest, get the water spell, and then I can defeat Karmak. And I guess that is not here, so I am gonna have to take some time to figure out multiple quests and figure out the answer to them, sadly. Signal the retreat. Okay, well, it wasn't because I wanted to do that, that's for sure. Don't be ashamed you were defeated. Your shame should not be in losing to my might. It should be in daring to pit your pitiful powers against mine. I will look forward to remaking our acquaintance when you return. That is, if you have any spine left for battle. Ha ha ha. Okay, well, that didn't feel good. The guards at Asai Castle were forced to retreat as well. The guards at Juron Castle were forced to retreat. They were all forced to retreat? We lost on all those fronts? Oh, you've got to be kidding me! You have got to be! Holy crap! You mean I have to do those battles again? Or what's that mean? Or does that mean that they were both forced to retreat? Let me see this. So what regions were those? Okay, well, I'm not seeing any new fronts along here, so... Okay, good. I don't think we have to refight. We have to Yeah, aside you're on. Okay. I was worried that means we're gonna have to refight on those fronts, but that's not what it meant. Okay. Okay, good. Alright, I was really worried. Anyways, I guess I'm gonna save the game, because I did make some progress, but not a lot, because I apparently have a lot of quests to do. So I'm gonna figure that out. If I have to use an FAQ, I will, but I'm gonna try to avoid it. Thank you very much for watching this episode of Dark Wizard. I'm sorry I couldn't make more progress, but that's how life goes sometimes. We're gonna overwrite our last save. And I will see you next time, fellow adventurers and worshippers of both light and darkness, or whatever. Anyways, I'll see you next time, brave adventurers and everyone else, in the next video. Good night.